Now let us study ray tracing and image formation in a convex mirror. To locate the image of any any number of rays from the object can be considered, but the three best rays to consider are as follows. This is a convex lens. This point called O, the optical center of the lens. On this side is air, on this side is air, a rarer medium. This is made of glass. The first best ray is a ray parallel to the principal axis, after refraction passes through the point focus. The first best ray. Actually, this ray will start bending from here, start getting refracted from here. But for the simplicity of the ray diagram, it is taken from this central vertical axis. This is the first best ray. And the second one is the ray passing through the focus after refraction becomes parallel to the principal axis. On this side is air, and also on this side is air, and this is made of glass. The third best ray is a ray passing through the optical center goes undeviated. So this is the third best ray. This is the focus. This is the focus. If light is coming from this side, then this is the focus. If light is coming from this side, then this is the focus. The distance from O to F, from O to F are equal. O to F are equal. And the distance is called focal length, f, which you will use in lens formula and lens maker's formula. Now, the different cases are as follows. Case one, when the object is at infinite distance. The object is at infinite distance, so the rays from it are parallel, because we know parallel rays, they meet at infinity. So if they are coming from infinity, they become parallel. They are parallel and parallel to the principal axis. So after refraction, they pass through the point focus. So here is the image of that very far off object which is at infinity. So the image is at F, it is real, highly diminished and inverted. Now the second aspect of it is, if the rays are parallel, look, these rays are parallel, but not parallel to the principal axis. This is the principal axis. These three rays are not parallel to the principal axis, but parallel to themselves. So after refraction, passing through O goes straight. This bends towards the thicker part. This is the thicker part of the lens, bends. This also bends. They arrive at here. So instead of getting focused at this point, they are focused on this focal plane. This is the focal plane. So they are focused here. So this is your image. This point is also the focus. Same focus as this. So you can find it is inverted. Now the second case. Object beyond 2F. This is the convex lens. Optical center. Focus here. Equidistant from O. This distance is same thing as this distance. So if I write F here, I have to write 2F here. Now object is beyond 2F. A ray parallel to the principal axis passes through the focus. A ray passing through the optical center goes undeviated. This ray was slightly wrongly drawn. So this is the image A dash B dash, and you find it is between F and 2F. It is actually formed, means if you put a screen here, you will get this image A dash B dash of the object AB. So the image is between F and 2F. It is real, it is inverted, diminished, small in size. If you look at A dash B dash, it is smaller in size than AB. Diminished, that is same thing as it is small in size. Then the third case, when the object is at... When the object is at a distance of 2F, this is the convex lens, optical center, F here, same distance here. This point is 2F and the object is here. A ray parallel to the principal axis passes through the focus, passing through the optical center goes undeviated. So this point is the image of A, because from here I have taken two rays after refraction, one from here and the one from here. After refraction through the lens, they meet at A dash. Therefore, A dash is the image of A. So A dash B dash. So A dash B dash, the image of AB. Now, this is F. This point is also 2F. So the image is actually formed here. It is real. It is inverted. It is at 2F. Same size as the object. Now, the fourth case, when the object is between F and 2F, the same convex lens, on this side AR, and on this side is also AR. F, 2F, here is the object AB, two rays are taken, this parallel passes through focus, passing through the optical center O, goes undeviated, they arrive at here, so therefore this is your A dash, this is your B dash, the image of AB. Now it is actually formed, it is real, it is beyond 2F, beyond 2F, it is inverted, upside down, enlarged, means magnified. Then the next case, when the object is at F, this is the convex lens, on this side is air, on this side is air, the rarer medium, this is made of glass. Now, this point is the focus and the object is also at the same point F, AB. Parallel passes through focus, as I have explained to you before. Passing through the optical center goes undeviated, so it goes to infinity. So the image is at infinity. So the image is real, it is inverted, extremely magnified. Now the last case, when the object, is between focus F and the optical center O of the lens. This is the lens, the optical center, from here to here is F. So 2F will be towards this side. Now the object AB is between optical center and focus. The object AB, a ray passing parallel, a ray parallel to the principal axis, after refraction will pass through the focus, as explained before. A ray going through, passing through the optical center goes straight. These two rays on this side, they are diverging, so they will not meet on this side. So this ray, when produced backward, and this ray when produced backward, both come from the point A dash. Therefore, A dash is the image of A. So A dash B dash is the image of AB. If you put a screen here, the image A dash B dash won't appear on the screen. Therefore, it is virtual. So it is a virtual, erect, magnified. All the above six cases are similar to concave mirror. But one important thing you have to remember, in case of a mirror, either a concave mirror or a convex mirror, we had proved R is equal to 2F, two times the focal length. But here, two times the focal length is not equal to the radius of curvature of the lens. For that, we'll derive a different formula, the relation between R, F, and the refractive index of the lens. We'll derive it in a different formula.